am a lawyer. A lawyer who can think, or who could think, once I am on the legs. Like I am a warrior. A soldier, however much he gets trained, the real talent of a soldier comes out only once he is in the battlefield. Once he is holding the gun and he is facing the enemy. I am sure I am also afraid for the future generation of lawyers, because today there are so many qualified company secretaries are coming, and they are all the potential lawyers, potential troublemakers, potential troubleshooters. See, as you see, there are so many youngsters, and realizing the importance of this profession, one of my niece, she had a good marks in intermediate, plus two, but she is a first class student, and she also got into couple of good engineering colleges, any branch of her choice. But then finally she came and asked me, "Uncle, what is it I should do? I'm not very keen on engineering. My father tells me to do engineering." Then I said, "Okay." She came a little late. She hasn't written the CLAT examination or the university law entrance examination. I advised her to join law, because it's easy for me to guide her and support her. But at the same time, simultaneously, I made her to enroll herself for the CS course. So that tells about how much of value I give to all of you and your profession. As told to you by the previous speakers, from 2013, the CS profession and CS course has taken a entirely a new dimension. It has gone to a new heights. The importance has increased so much that initially I thought I should mention all that, but then I realized in the very ICSI, the pamphlet which is there, they have mentioned about all the plus things which have happened after 2013. So there is no point in mentioning which is available in books. As I said, all of the previous speakers have virtually robbed what all I could speak with respect to the profession, or to encourage you, or to enthuse you, or to propel you to the next heights which you deserve. I need to speak. I'm faced with that dilemma. Then I realized there's always place for a man who can differentiate. That differentiation is what I would like to point out today. See, all the speakers have told you about, many a times I had seen, in fact I am associated with this federation for last 30 years. I'm virtually grew up in this place. So it's every inch of this place is familiar to me, and every employee in this place are familiar to me. In the last of the term when I left, probably I would have been the next president or vice president in this place. That time I left and I changed the profession from advocacy to judgeship. Coming back to the thing, see, all the speakers have told about what you gain and what you would get in your personal level. And they also, one of the speakers, though I know who is the one, but I don't want to discriminate among them, because all the three were so exceptionally good that it is difficult for me to point out who is good, who is not bad, good, that who told what, and also it's very difficult to comprehend at this stage. But the three pillars have been mentioned: career, family and health, to be taken care of by you. I go a little further and say that is with respect to the individual level. I want all of you to think about the society in which you are living in, the country in which you are living in. Well, when it comes to compliances, of various compliances which you ensure for a company, for an entrepreneur, for a person, the who is putting the money, running the industry, etc., industry, company, whatever it is, enterprise. I would like you people to be raised little more above and think about your society, your country, and participate in that particular aspect of the compliances as required to be complied in a country, in every aspect of life, not only with respect to your company's compliances or an enterprise compliances. Basically, everything will turn out to be in the end on one single word: to be a good citizen. Then how do you, what is this being a good citizen? You know, in India, there's this concept, you know, we are all used to, especially Hyderabadis, we are all used to one word, chalta hai. What is this? Chalta hai. Chalega. That a particular point of time, if we continue like this, as a citizens, if we do not behave the way we have to behave, if we do not comply with the norms of the society, which are being well-established norms, there would be no society existing for you and for your children in the future. I want all of you to think very deeply on this aspect of the matter. I'll give you the simplest example. All of you are from, you know, I studied in Bangalore for some time. I've been living in Hyderabad for quite some time. I was a regular visitor to Delhi. In my professional life, I traveled almost into all the cities and all the towns, small towns, big towns. One thing which I find common in everybody's, in Indian culture, it has been built, it's come as Indian culture, unfortunately, that non-compliance with anything relating to a rule. What is it? Non-compliance with a rule, non-compliance with a basic norms of a citizen. Simplest example which I can give you is, except in Mumbai, even Mumbai also now is, they are also falling into the same line again. People don't stand anywhere in the queue. The slightest opportunity, I would like to jump the lane. The slightest opportunity, I would like to jump the red light. The slightest opportunity, I would like to overtake the other man and go forward. In the vehicles, if you see on the road, you start observing from yourself, at least if I am motivating about 100-150 people today, I think my day is done and my time which I am giving to all of my friends here at the request of XYZ here, who are all my old friends, many of them are my old friends. I think I have, that my day is made. I take it that way. I believe in the success by small measures. The success which I am looking forward from my side is, having left a very lucrative practice, for all your information, I had one of the probably the top 5 or 10 lawyers of the state, and I also will stand in queue in the overall, in the country level also. I left for a just salary of about 18 lakhs per annum. You may think that 18 lakhs, wow, it's a big figure. No. I was making almost 10 to 20 times of that money. I left that to be a part of the system, to ensure that society, I will be able to contribute to something to society. For the simple reason, one of the seniors of mine, I left the practice because one of the seniors told me a very significant statement which he has made, and I want you people to think it over. Here there are also parents who have sacrificed their life, blood and their time and money and everything for you people, youngsters, but you are the future. So for that reason I would like to implore, and if I am able to make impact for about 100 people here, my day is made for this particular day, and your 100 people, you in turn, I am sure, you will likewise impress upon another 100, it will multiply in no time. This will be a kind of momentum. So as he said, the three pillars, career, family and health, I would only say with a simple thing, I would like you to be true Bharat. My daughter's name is Bharati. I named her as Bharati for the reason, after a year I heard a discourse from one of the gurus. What does Bharat means? Is there any meaning? Then the Guru said, Bhava Rag Tal. Your thought, word, deed. If there is a synchronization, if there is a synchrony, like I think something, I do the same thing. I speak the same thing. Whatever I speak, I do the same thing, my behavior. Thought is the germination of the thought. The word is, I speak only truth or whatever I need to speak, which is right. Then the third thing is, I conform to my word. I behave in the society what I tell. Then you become a true Bharat. I wish, I want you to be a true Bharat, like I have been. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity.